Have you guys ever felt lonely?
At some point, yes. Of course.
Of course, we're not lonely right now.
No, we're having fun.
We're happy, right?
Yeah.
Cool. Next question. Have you ever felt isolated?
What's the difference?
Mga Kanation, maybe you guys are also asking the same question. So, let's talk about just that and the resources to help you get through one or the other. Let's do it. Thanks, Randy and Alan.
Thank you.
Hello, Mocky Nation. So, it might be ironic to think that in this digital age where everything and everyone seems so connected, one can still feel isolated, but it does happen. And even more so, research has shown that isolation can actually negatively affect your life, especially for older adults. And here to share with us the importance of social connections and the resources to maintain them is AARP's Chief Medical Officer, Dr. Charlotte Yeh. Welcome to Adobe Nation.
Thank you very much for having me.
Of course. So what exactly does it mean to be isolated? And is it the same as the feeling of loneliness?
So that's a great question.
Yeah.
So isolation and loneliness are very big, serious issues for the older adult. So to understand it, isolation is actually an objective number. It's quantifiable. How many friends do you have? Mm-hmm. How big is your network? How accessible is transportation? Can you get around? Whereas loneliness is how you feel about it. So you could have many friends and be lonely. Or you could live alone and not be lonely.
Right. So it kind of goes hand in hand in a way.
Yeah, they're very connected. They're very related to each other, but they're slightly different.
Okay, so who exactly is at risk? I mean, obviously isolation can connect with anyone of age, but who is our main, is there a main group that isolation sort of lean towards more?
So think of three groups. One is your health, and hearing loss is a huge factor. Anywhere,
definitely.
You know, 2/3 of people 70 and older have hearing loss, and if you mm-hmm. can't communicate, it makes you both isolated and lonely. A second big group would be when you retire, you'd start losing your friends from work and have to create new friends. For the Asian community, it's language and culture. We're used to living in multi-generational families.
Oh, definitely.
And speaking with people who speak our language.
It's a big transition for us, of course.
But as your friends or your spouse begin to die off or age and aren't as mobile, you can become lonely and isolated. And then finally, if you have low income, you may be at more risk because you can't have transportation, you may not have a car, there may not be public transportation.
Right.
You can't get to the local community activities.
Something so small can trigger isolation in someone. So how does isolation impact someone's health?
So surprisingly, isolation and loneliness have a huge impact on health. In fact, it can increase your risk of early death anywhere from 26 to 40%, about 29% increase in heart disease, 32% increase in strokes, depression. In fact, loneliness is thought to have the same health impact as 15 cigarettes of smoking a day.
Wow.
Even more than
loneliness.
Obesity.
Yep. That's the effect that it has on our body.
Right. The stress hormones go up, depression. It is hugely impactful. And with hearing loss, it can increase your risk of dementia.
Wow. Okay. So with that said, I mean, what are some of the signs that we can look for with our relatives? You know, while you're telling me this, I'm thinking about my grandma or my Lola. So what are some of the signs that we can look for?
So it's sometimes can be very hard to tell because no one wants to admit that they're lonely, right? It's a huge stigma.
Mm-hmm.
But if you see someone who's staying pretty much at home, your parents, your grandparents, you know, neighbors who aren't getting out of the house, someone who has mobility issues, maybe doesn't have a car, can't get out of the house, maybe a recent death in the family, loss of a spouse, those are really the people you want to reach out to.
Yeah, of course. So with all of this information said, if our viewers want to know more information about this topic of isolation and loneliness, how can we go about this?
Well, I'm so glad you asked. The AARP Foundation has a wonderful website called Connect to Affect. You can go to that website. It will have tools, resources, more information about isolation and loneliness and what you can do.
All right. Thank you so much, Dr. Charlotte Yeh, for that wealth of information.
Thank you.
All right. Please do not be afraid to reach out to your loved ones, your fellow couple buy-ins, or any other resources out there to help you get in touch with that.